Welcome to this new video about new operators in LINQ. Today I will show you, which element operators do we have for LINQ. Before I start, if you want to learn more about LINQ and UiPath, please check the other LINQ videos on my channel. You can find different links about LINQ in the video description. Let's go! Element operators in LINQ are used to return a single element from a data source using the element index or based on a condition. In a LINQ query we have the following 9 element operators. ElementAt. ElementAt or default. First. First or default. Last. Last or default. Single. Single or default. And the last one is default if empty. Except this operator, all 8 operators return a single element. As you see, we have the same operator 2 times. On the right side are the operators with, or default. On the left side we have the operators without anything. For example, first and first or default. Last and last or default, and so on. What is the difference between both? When to use which one? And which one is recommended to use? In this video I will explain the first 2 operators, element at and element at or default. In the next videos I will explain the other operators. Before I start explaining the operators, let me first show you one important point, which you have to know about LINQ, so that you can understand why we use element operators. A LINQ query returns normally a sequence of results or also nothing. It depends on the query and the conditions we have in the query. Assume we get a result containing more than one element. The result is a collection of elements. Sometimes we don't need to get all elements, but only one specific element. To get it we can use element operators. For example, the following query. Here I have a query to get the numbers from an array, which are greater than 3. The result of this query is a collection of integer numbers. The result looks like this one. As you see, we have all numbers, which are greater than 3. The numbers are the elements. Assume I don't need the entire result, but only a single specific element. To do that we can use the index of the element, or we can set a condition. The index for the elements is as follows. The first element has always the index 0. The next element has the index 1. The element after it has the index 2, and so on. So the index starts always with 0. If we want to get the first element, we can use the index 0. Or as mentioned, we can set a condition to get a specific element. That's why we use element operators. Let's go back and start with the first 2 operators, element at and element at or default. I will start with the first one, element at. Element at returns the element at a specified index in a sequence. It means that we use an index to get only one element. Let's see the following query to understand it better. I have the same query to get the numbers, which are greater than 3. The result of this query is the following collection, which contains these 3 numbers. Assume I want to get the second element from the result. It's the number 9. As mentioned, the index starts with 0. So the index for the second element is 1. To get this element I will use element at operator in this way. I only set the operator with the index in brackets. The result of this query will be the number 9. To get the third element I can set the index 2. In this case I will get the number 4 as result. And so on, we can get any element we need using its index. Using this operator we could get the following exception, argument out of range exception. This appears if I am using an index, which I don't have in the sequence. For example, this query returns the following 3 numbers. Assume I am using the operator element at with the index 5. As you know, we don't have the index 5 here, because we only have 3 elements. It means we only have indexes from 0 to 2. In this case, an exception of type argument out of range exception will be thrown. How can we fix that? We can use the second operator, element at or default. What does it mean and how it works? Let's see. This operator also returns the element at a specified index in a sequence, or a default value if the index is out of range. This means, if we have the index in the sequence, we will get the element at this index. But if we don't have the index, we will get the default value as output. The default value is always depending on the data type we have in the collection. For example, in this query we have a collection of integer numbers. It means we have an integer data type. The default value for integer numbers is 0. This means if I am using element at or default with the index 5, I will get the result 0. I got 0 because I don't have the index 5. Therefore I got the default value for an integer number. It means we don't get an exception anymore, but the default value. Let's check another query about another data type. For example, the following query to loop an array of Boolean and get only the elements, which are true. The result of this query contains only one element, true. I want to get the element at index 3. As you see, I don't have the index 3, so I should get the default value. So we have here Boolean collection, therefore we should get the default value of a Boolean data type. The default value for Boolean is false. So we will get false as output. This is how can we use this operator in a LINQ query. But how do I know which default value has a specific data type? Just search for it in this way. Write the data type and then default value. For example, integer default value, and you will get the default value. In this case it's 0. This is how to know which default value there is for a specific data type. Before I switch to UiPath, let me summarize these two operators. ElementAt returns the element at a specific index, if we have the index. But if we don't have the index, an exception of type argument out of range exception will be thrown. ElementAtOrDefault returns also the element at a specific index. But if we don't have the index, the default value will be returned. We have only one overload for both operators. We write the operator and the index in brackets. We can use both operators only as method. It means we can use them in method syntax or in a mixed syntax. That's all what you have to know about these two operators. Let's now switch to UiPath to implement some examples. The first example is about arrays. How can we get the max or min number of an array using ElementAt operator? I have here a variable. It's of type integer array. It contains the numbers from 1 to 9. And here I have another variable of type integer. I want to store the max number in this variable later. Here I have a LINQ query to get the max number. It's very simple query. I only use the array variable with the operator max. Then I want to print out the max number. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I got the number 9, which is the max number in the array. Now I will change the query to get the max number, but now using the new operator, ElementAt. First, I use the operator order by descending to sort the numbers in descending order. X represents the numbers of the array. This means that the array now looks like this one here. I have the biggest number at the beginning and the smallest number at the end. Now using the ElementAt operator with index 0 means that I want to get the max number, which is now at the first index. Let's execute the code to check if it works. As you see, I got the same number, 9, which is the biggest one in the array. In this way we can also get the max number without using max operator. Of course using max operator is easier and better, but this is only an example to show you, how can we use the operator ElementAt. Let's now try to get the min number of the array, but without using min operator, but using ElementAt operator. First I will create a variable to store the result. It should be of type integer. I will use the variable here. And now I have two ways to get the min number using ElementAt operator. The first way is to use the operator, order by. In this case the array will be sorted in ascending order. Or I can change the index for ElementAt operator. Let's try to change the index. As you know, the smallest number of the array is now at the last index. To get the last index we can use the array variable with the operator count. The array contains 9 numbers, which means that this expression returns a number 9. But as you know, the index starts always with 0, therefore I have to set minus 1. So the result here is 8, which represents the last index. In this way I will get the last number from the array, which is the smallest one. Let's execute the code again and check which number will we get as result. As you see, I got the number 1, which is the smallest one in the array. This is how to use ElementAt operator to get max or min number of an array. We can also write the same queries with the operator, ElementAtOrDefault. Using this operator I will get the same results, what I got using ElementAt operator. Let's now move on to the next example about data tables. In this example I want to show you, how to use the following operators in a LINQ query. Group, order by descending an element at. I have a build data table activity, where I define a data table. It's stored in this variable. It's of type data table. Let's see the table. It consists of two columns, customer ID and order date. I have here different customers and also different dates. One customer could appear more than once in the table. But for the same customer we have different dates. These dates indicate when this customer ordered. A date is structured as following. We first have the month, then the day, and the last one is the year. I want to write a LINQ query to get the newest date, when a customer ordered. It means for example the customer 1 ordered 3 times. I want to get this date as output, because this date is the newest one. And I want to do that for each customer. Customer 2 ordered only once, so I should get this date. And customer 3 ordered 2 times, therefore I want to get this date, because it's the newest date. Let's see how can we do that. I will add an assign activity to write the query. I want to save the result in the same data table variable, but you can create a new table to store the result. I will first write the query, then I will explain it in detail. First I loop the rows of the data table. After that I group the rows using the column customer ID. The group will be stored in this variable. In this way I will have all rows of one customer in a group. As you know we have 3 customers in the table, therefore I will have 3 groups. Each group contains as mentioned the rows of the specific customer. After grouping the rows we want to sort the rows in each group in descending order. It means, that the newest date will be at the beginning, and the oldest date will be at the end of each group. At the end I will take the first element from each group. It means I will take the first row from each group. In this way I will get only one row for each customer. This row contains the newest date. After the query I have this function, to convert the output to data table. Now I will add for each row activity, to print out the content of the table, so that you can check the result. I added this statement to print out the content of the both columns. And now I will execute the code. As you see, I have only 3 rows as output, because I have only 3 customers. For each customer there is only 1 row. Let's check the date for each customer. Customer 1 has 3 rows in the data table. We got this date as output, which is the newest one between the 3 dates. Customer 2 has only 1 date, therefore we got it. And customer 3 has 2 rows. We got this date, because it's the newest one between the both. By the way, we can use the same query without order operator to get the unique rows from a data table. The query looks like this one. Using this query we can get the unique rows using one column, customer ID, because this column is the primary key in my table. But we can also use other columns, if the primary key consists of more than one column. Let's now edit the query to get the oldest date for each customer. It means I want to find out, when is a customer ordered for the first time. I can only change the operator order by descending to order by. Or I can change the index to get the last row in the group, because the last row contains the oldest date. I will change the index. I will do the same as I did for the array in the previous example. I will use the group count minus 1. In this way I will get the last row from each group, which also contains the oldest date for one customer. Let's execute the code again to check the new result. I have again only 3 rows. The date for customer 1 is this one, which is the oldest one. The date for customer 2 is the same, because I have only 1 row for this customer. And the date for customer 3 is also the oldest one. It works also fine. I use the operator element at, but I can also use the operator element at or default, and I will get the same result. This is how to use these two operators to get a specific element from a sequence. I hope you enjoyed the video and could learn these two operators better now. If you still have any questions about these two operators, please don't hesitate to write us in a comment. Thanks for watching and have a great day.